Oh, hi there. Yeah, don't mind me, just laying on this beautiful beach, thinking about life. It's been a little bit though. How you all doing? I know, I'm sorry. That's kind of a loaded question at this moment. 2020, am I right? What a year. I'm sure anybody watching this might be wondering, what's Carter been up to? He hasn't been posting much at all during 2020. But hey, now that it's 2021, let's talk about it. Now, I'm positive, not COVID-19 positive, but positive that 2020 has been easily the worst year of a tremendous amount of people's lives. Let's see, there were those Australian bushfires, Kobe Bryant and his daughter's death, may they both rest in peace, the stock market crashing, the whole George Floyd incident, may he also rest in peace, leading up to the Black Lives Matter movement, which also led to a whole bunch of protesting and even rioting. Chadwick Boseman's death, may he also rest in peace, Wakanda forever, West Coast wildfires, all the political stuff with Donald Trump and Joe Biden, so much stress and so many bad things happening in this one year. And I almost forgot about the virus.
Out to the surging coronavirus crisis.
Coronavirus.
Coronavirus pandemic. As of today, more than 9 million people in the United States have been infected. More than 230,000 have died.
COVID-19 has easily become one of the biggest moments in our history. It's been a full time of panicking, frustration, and depression, killing hundreds of thousands, forcing people to stay in their homes, being unable to connect with their friends and families face to face. This pandemic, while literally killing so many people, has also been killing people on the inside, our mentality, our emotional states. Being secluded in our homes, trapped with the fear of our own thoughts, stuck waiting in your house for this virus to go away so we can get back to our normal lives. For me, this year was a lot to take in. I had to stay in my home along with all of you. I wasn't able to see my friends. I wasn't able to go to places. I wasn't able to see my girlfriend, who at the time I just got together with. I lost two grandmas, one dying of old age and one dying of ALS. In the same year of getting together, my girlfriend broke up with me, which was actually my first time getting broken up with. All these negative experiences happening to me put a lot of negative thoughts into my head, making me lose sense of who I was. Who was I? I didn't know. I was lost. During this time, a lot of people felt lost. They didn't realize how much they didn't know about themselves, and having that kind of feeling inside of you can be terrifying. Eventually leading to depression. But if you never get lost in your life, you can also never be found. In that time of not knowing who I was, I took that time to learn. When I was eventually allowed to see my friends and family again, I began listening to myself and figured out a little more of what my interests were. One of my friends showed me that I can relax and have fun riding a longboard, so I bought one to ride. One of my other friends allowed me to play on his guitar, which made me want to purchase my own, and I did. And my uncle has been showing me the ropes of how to play. Having me time, I figured out that I'm more sensitive and caring than I thought. For example, put on a sad movie, and I'll probably cry. Me going to school for my senior year this year has made me realize what career path I want to follow. And there are so much more things I've learned about myself, but for the sake of this video and time, I'll just say there's way more. 2020 was also a year of learning valuable life lessons for me. Dealing with death has taught me to not take things for granted. Experiencing heartbreak has taught me that a relationship cannot work if one person in that relationship is unhappy. It's okay to take a step back to figure out who you are, and it's also important to move on, to not dwell on the past, to continue to push to be the best of yourself. The end of 2020 and the beginning of 2021 was a good start to becoming a new me. I took my time throughout January to plan out my future and waited until February to take action. And guess what month it is? That's right, people, it's February. If you haven't figured it out by now, this video has been leading up to the return of something. Someone big and someone important. Me. I know, right? Everything you guys wanted in life. Yup, here I am. That's right, I am back. And I got info on things for my channel that you can all look forward to. Coming back to YouTube, I'm bringing back with me the biggest amount of creative energy I've ever had in the longest time, with a fiery desire to produce more content for you all to enjoy. For my return, I'll also be having much more fun playing Minecraft with friends. I'll also be bringing back more episodes of my own podcast, The Slime Ball, where I'll be joined with the two other hosts of the show, Novanium and Frost Titan Gaming. We've made a new studio for the podcast, which looks absolutely sick. Here's a little montage. I'll be uploading more frequently and also livestream more. The Slime Squad will, mark my words, will finally hit 900 subscribers. Once we hit that milestone, I'll be launching a new channel where I'll be playing different games other than Minecraft. And then, oh ho ho, we're coming straight for you 1000 subs. And once we do, I'll be doing my face reveal. But wait, it doesn't end there, there's more. Once I do hit 1000 subscribers on my channel, I'll also be releasing another channel where I'll be doing all sorts of stuff like real life challenges, pranks, vlogs, and more. I know I'm saying a lot, and it's a lot to take in, and it may even seem impossible to accomplish, but together we have the power to do great things, to make a great impact on this world. I know I've said a lot of things in the past where it seems like I'm a liar, but that was never my intentions, and I want to apologize to you all from the very bottom of my heart. I am sorry. Now that I've told you about myself within the past year, now you're all caught up. I hope you all can understand maybe why I've been so inconsistent. You all probably thought that this year would be the end of my channel, CJT Slime. But this is just the beginning.